Let's go, YouTube! What's good, YouTube? It's That Fantasy Network, and I'm your host, That Fantasy Guy, and we back with another rookie profile special. And today we're talking about the infamous Malik Willis. If y'all remember, hype was super high on this guy during the offseason. Before the draft, many thought he was going to be the first quarterback off the board. I personally had Kenneth Pickett rated as my number one QB. And if I was to choose another quarterback that I thought was ready, it was actually Ritter. But Malik Willis definitely has some traits I like, so let's get into it. Malik Willis was out of Liberty, drafted by the Titans in the third round, 22nd pick, 6 foot, 219, did not compete in any of the athletic testing in a combine, but we do have an old 40 on him prior to college, which was a 4.63. If the man ran a 4.63 as a QB before he got to college, you know he fast. Three-star recruit. Looked pretty accurate from the film. Always was willing to run the ball. He was a goal line threat. Willing to throw deep. Scrambled well in the pocket. I only saw that he really only threw to open wide receivers, which means he's not one of them guys that's going to throw a back shoulder throw or throw contested catches. At least that's not what I seen on film. He was on a Bruce Feldon freak list. I do knock him for being only 6 foot. I like my quarterbacks at least 6'2", and I give him a knock for being a redshirt senior. But as far as his production, he gave like a 29% run rate, you know, when it came to his production. And that screams fantasy points. I mean, you love a rushing quarterback. You give me, if you rushing over 25% of your production, you already know that's going to be equivalent to fantasy points. He had 9.5-inch hands. I like my quarterback to have 10-inch hands. Closer to 10, the better. He stood out during the Senior Bowl, and he hit that mark of the 25% rush rate, as I was saying. So I really did like this guy. I really did like this guy on film. But one of the things, I'm not even going to pretend to be a quarterback guru. And I kept hearing that he's not ready. He's not going to be able to start. And I think we've seen that. Anytime he got in, he has not looked good. He may be playing against Houston. This is going to be his best opportunity to do anything against a bad defense. If he's not able to do anything against Houston, he might not have a future in this league. There's a good chance there might not be a future for him in this league. Now, like I was saying, there was a bunch of hype on this quarterback, thinking he was going to be the first one off the board. And the man not only ended up being the third quarterback off the board, but he didn't get drafted till the third round. And if you listen to any of my thoughts on Malik Willis, I always say he would be the 101 for rookie drafts if he was drafted to the Steelers, because I believe in the Steelers organization, you know. So if you put that behind this rushing mobile quarterback with a stable organization, hey, I was going to be backing him up totally. But when he didn't go there and didn't even get the first round draft capital, I was out. I'll let someone else bet on him. I mean, not only didn't he get the first round draft capital, he went to a situation where I feel the quarterback that's there is better than him. And that might be, he might hope to get to Tannehill's ceiling, you know. He might hope to get there because the processing speed is not up to par. You know, unless you have an offensive coordinator that runs a very simple offense that allows him to utilize his leg and not have to think much, he's going to have trouble. So he should be on a waiver wire in all redraft leagues, pretty much, unless you're in some kind of league like I'm in. I'm in like a 14-man super flex, and they are quarterback thirsty, so he's been rostered. As soon as he was dropped, like, someone picked him up again. It's, you know, Ritter been rostered for a while. It's like they're all quarterback hungry. So, you know, in some super flex, them hearing this news, he probably was picked off the waiver wire that he may get a start. But in one quarterback leagues, he is buried on the waiver wire. And of course, you're not going to touch him until you decide whether he actually get the starting job or he's able to start again. But if you do believe in Malik Willis, it's just show this sure would be the spot to start him. Because if he can't do anything against Houston, I don't know what to say. Now, his dynasty value currently, a second rounder. Like, you know, whoever has Malik Willis believes in Malik Willis. That's the only thing about trying to trade for players. People make it seem easy, but usually the players that someone has, they believe in. So it's not as easy, unless they're fed up with them, to get them off their team. So they might not let him go for, you know, less than a second. And who knows? Probably some people might be, I want to see what happens. Now, what are my beliefs? What will happen with Malik Willis? I don't know. I told you, if he finds an offensive coordinator that could simplify the offense and just build off him being able to run and his arm strength, if he's going to start and the team is not going to be quick to yank him, then he's going to start producing serious fantasy numbers. But if you're expecting him to go out there, run the same offense that Tannehill does, process fast, go through the reads fast, all this, good chance he's not going to make it in the NFL. But I ain't going to hold you guys. Peace.